The second type is covalent solids. The second type of crystalline solids is covalent solids. Covalent solids. In covalent solids, the constituent particles are non-metallic atoms. These are held strongly together. And these atoms are very strongly at their lattice point. And these atoms are very strongly at their lattice points. Andre avugla lattice points andre positionally tumba strong agi hold agirutta. Therefore, do not conduct electricity. Means insulators. These are the called insulator, means it do not conduct electricity because absence of free electrons. Andre free electrons irodilla because the atoms are, means the constituent particles are held very strongly to each other, and these are very hard and brittle. Hard agirutte matte ade riti brittle agirutte. You know, hard is nothing but jaasi gatti agirutte, brittle andre bega hodidogutte anta. So hard and brittle, this is the detail about covalent solids. Means the covalent solids, the constituent particles are non-metallic atoms, and these are held strongly together, and these atoms are very strongly at their lattice points. Therefore, do not conduct electricity, it means insulator, because absence of free electrons. And these are very hard and brittle. Therefore, it has high melting point. High melting point irutte ekende hard and brittle agirodinda. Example for covalent solids, take diamond, comma graphite and silicon carbide, comma quartz, etc. Here all these example for covalent solids, and except graphite, and all these are insulator. This graphite is non-insulator. It means conductor. These all are example for covalent solids only. And observe here, I told all these covalent solids are do not conduct electricity, hence they are called insulators. But the graphite is an example for covalent solids, even though it conducts electricity due to presence of unsaturation. Double bond, single bond, alternative agirodrinda graphite anodu conduct madutte electricity anna. So the third type of crystalline solid is metallic solid. In metallic solids, the constituent particles are metal ions. Are atoms, and these are held strongly by a metallic bond. These are held strongly by metallic bond. And you know the metallic bond is very strong bond, therefore it has high melting point. Or widely it has very high melting point. Tumba melting point irutte, jaase high melting point irutte. Yaake high melting point irutte andre, due to presence of strong metallic bond. Metallic bond is strong, therefore it has high melting point. Hence these are malleable, comma ductile and brittle. These are the metallic physical properties. So you know all metals have malleable in nature and ductile in nature and brittle in nature. Ella metals malleable, ductile, brittle agirutte. Malleable andre mettigirutte, ductile andre it can be stretched into a thin wire. Ductile andre ondu sand wire tara stretch maadabodu. For example, take gold anta goli. ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ನಾವು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ತಿನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು, ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ವೈರ್ ಇನ್ ನ್ಯಾನೋ ಸೈಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವೈರ್ ತರ ನಾವು ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು. ಅದನ್ನ ಡಕ್ಟೈಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಇನ್ನೋ ಬ್ರಿಟೈಲ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಗಟ್ಟಿ ಅಂತ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಸಾರಿ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಹೀಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿಯನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿ ಆಲ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅಯಾನ್ಸ್, ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ. And right, these conduct electricity and thermal energy or thermal conductivity. These are electrical conductors and also thermal conductors. And now take example for metallic solids. Example for metallic solids: sodium, zinc, copper, bronze or brass, bronze, etc. These are the some example for metallic conductors. ಇವನ್ನ ನಾವು ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ನಾವು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜಿಂಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗುಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಾಪರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ನೋ ಗುಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ದೇ ಫೋರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಗುಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ, ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್, ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್. ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲೈನ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್. In molecular solids, the constituent particles are atoms, and all these molecular solids are soft and low melting point. Soft agirodrinda low melting point irutte. All these molecular solids are soft and low melting point, hence they also exist in liquid or gaseous state at room temperature and pressure. Room temperature and pressure. At this condition, these molecular solids also exist either in liquid state or gaseous state, and these are very soft, therefore it has low melting point. And remember, here the constituent particles are atoms or ions or molecules. These are the constituent particles. Now, based on the nature of force held between the atoms na madde yav tara force ide anta molecular solids anna three types of classify martivi, that is based on based on the nature of force. Nature of force binding between atoms can be classified into three types. Based on the nature of force held between or present between the atom can be classified into three types. Andre molecular solids nalliruvanta atoms na madde yav tara force ide anta nodkonbittu navu three types avi classify maartta idivi. That is, the first type is non-polar molecular solids. Non-polar molecular solids. In non-polar molecular solids, the particles or molecules are non-polar covalent bond in nature. In non-polar molecular solids, the particles means the constituent particles. Particles or atoms or molecules of non-polar covalent bonds agirutte ee constituent particles na madde yav tara force irutandre non-polar covalent bond force irutte. And these constituent particles are held together weak London force or dispersive force. Very very important, remember, the non-polar molecules means these constituent particles are held together by a weak London force or dispersion force. Important, remember, these non-polar molecules are very non-polar in nature, therefore they have or they hold together by weak London force or dispersion force. London force athwa dispersion force ninda ee molecular solids anadu hold agirutte. Now second type, polar molecular solids. Polar molecular solids. In these polar molecular solids, the constituent particles are in polar covalent bond in nature. In these solids, they held together by a relatively a strong dipole-dipole interaction force. These polar molecular solids are held together by strong dipole-dipole interaction force. Now write, the constituent particles or atoms or molecules are held together by a polar covalent bond, right? The constituent particles or atoms or molecules of polar covalent bond. Polar covalent bond. And these are held by together with a strong dipole-dipole interaction. These constituent particles are held together by a strong dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole interaction in the andre such kind of force is present between the polar molecular solids madde ee dipole-dipole interaction anno force anodu irutte. Tumba important kelthare, what type of force present between the polar molecular solids alli dipole-dipole interaction irutte. नॉन पोलर मॉलिक्यूलर सॉलिड्स अल्ली वीक लंडन फोर्स अथवा डिस्पर्शन फोर्स अंत करीतीवि हियर ऑब्जर्व द लंडन फोर्स आर डिस्पर्शन फोर्स इज एन ए वीक फोर्स एंड डाइपोल डाइपोल इंटरैक्शन फोर्स इज एन ए स्ट्रांग फोर्स ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ವಾ? ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಡೈಪೋಲ್ ಡೈಪೋಲ್ ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್. ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ In hydrogen bonded molecular solids, the constituent particles are molecules. These containing polar covalent bond and between hydrogen and one of the more electronegative atoms such as fluorine or oxygen or nitrogen atoms. Observe here the constituent particles. The constituent particles are molecular. Sorry, constituent particles are molecules. Constituent particles are molecules, and these containing are these held by a polar covalent bond. Covalent bond between hydrogen and more electronegative atoms, hydrogen and more electronegative atoms such as either fluorine or nitrogen or oxygen or etc. with these atoms, and the binding force is strong hydrogen bond. Here the binding force is strong hydrogen bond. Strong hydrogen bond. So observe here, the force is hydrogen bonding force. Hydrogen bonding force in this case, hydrogen molecular solids means in the case of hydrogen molecular solids, the binding force is hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding, and the constituent particles here is the molecules. For example, take ice means water, or take solid ammonia. NH3 solid, solid ammonia, or take HCl. HCl, now here not HCl, ammonia, or take some weak bonds present between paranitrotoluene, P-nitro, aniline, or toluene, etc. So these are the some examples for hydrogen bonded molecular solids. So ivlanella hydrogen bonded molecular solids irutte. For example, ice anod nodi, ice is nothing but water. So water molecule yavtara irutte, H bond H. Here there is a lone pair electrons on oxygen, and write one more molecule of water. Here the bond, weak hydrogen bond is present between hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen oxygen madhe ondu weak hydrogen bond ide. This is the hydrogen bonding force, that is the strong hydrogen bonding force present between these two atoms. Actually this bond is weak bond, idu weak bond agirutte, but ee molecules madhe strong agi ee force irutte anta helta idivi. Artha aitalva? So such type of solids we called hydrogen bonded molecular solids. And here observe, in polar molecular solids, take example for HCl, polar HCl, or HBr. These are the solid HCl and solid HBr is the example for polar molecular solids. Or you take solid sulfur dioxide, etc. These are the example for polar molecular solids. And for example for non-polar molecular solids, non-polar irbeku. Non-polar means take hydrogen or solid iodine, etc. Or chlorine. These are the non-polar. Andre polarity anodu illa illi. These are the example for molecular solids and their types and examples.